Hey guys, this is Nicole, and once again, I apologize for my voice. It sounds horrible, I know. I'm losing it due to a cold that I've had the last couple of days. But I wanted to get my next kit set up, and this one's going to be a little bit different. This is actually for an album. Normally when I have like vacations and things, I allow myself to just work on it as I feel like it, and I use different paper lines as long as it all kind of feels the same. This one I'm going to do a little bit differently. I'm not going to use just like one paper line, because that's another thing that I've done, is just use like one paper line for the whole album. This is actually going to be, this one's a little tricky because it's actually a trip that we took over Christmas. And so the pictures are vacation, yet they're also a lot of them are very Christmassy because we went to the Mall of America, and so we had lots of pictures in front of Christmas trees and different things throughout the entire vacation. So it's like Christmassy yet not Christmassy. And so what I decided to do was pull all my brighter colored Christmas kits and Christmas paper lines and some embellishments. And I'm going to try to use that for the entire album. So it's actually like 3 or 4 different lines. It's a variety of products. So I'm kind of sticking with one large kit for this album, but it's a variety of different paper lines. And a lot of times Christmas paper lines have papers in them that aren't necessarily all Christmassy themed. You know, they'll have like a chevron or a pattern that isn't necessarily Christmas, but it goes along with the rest of the papers that are Christmas themed. And so I figured I would intersperse those throughout the album for the layouts and pocket pages that aren't, you know, super Christmassy or don't need to be Christmassy, if that makes any sense. I'm going to really quickly show you how I have this set up here. So this is the album I'm going to use, and I'm using this because I like how it has like the red and green, but then it has lots of fun colors to it, which is what this album is going to be. It's going to be very colorful. And I've already put all the pictures into pocket pages, and I did this with my Disney album. It's the same thing. And so if you kind of look at these photos, you can see that there's lots of color. We're at the Mall of America, so you have all these beautiful, crazy, like, really cool colors, and just it's very bright and sparkly, and like here you have these orange Christmas trees. And so I wanted to you know, use product that would go along well with that. And then you also have a lot of pink. We went to the American Girl store, and so we had lots of pink going on, but yet still Christmassy because they're in front of the American Girl Christmas tree. And so anyway, so I have all the pictures laid out in here from our, we were there I think 4 days, and then I'm just going to grab the photos as I feel like scrapbooking them. I've also put like ephemera and different things in pockets, some of the photos that we paid for in this larger protector, and then I'll figure out how I want to scrapbook those. So they're already in here and ready to go. We were actually there on Christmas Day, so we do have some actual Christmas photos in front of a tree. Those will have, you know, I'll pull the more really Christmassy themed product for that. Christmas morning was there. The girls are wearing very bright pajamas, and so I just think that this is going to be the best way to go for this album. So here we did a drive-through Christmas scenic tour. And so anyway, so as you can see, it's a variety of Christmassy and non-Christmassy. So I think this is going to be my best bet for handling this album, since it was a Christmas trip. So really quickly, hopefully I don't run out of time here, I'm going to show you the product I have pulled. And okay, so I pulled a few different paper lines, and I think this is, I believe this is Crepe Paper Bundled Up, which I've already played with a little bit, but I'm going to use that some more. I have Silent Night by, I think, October Afternoon. Again, very bright, colorful, pretty colors. Anything that pretty much had the pink tones in them, I went with. And then the Studio Calico, 'Tis the Season, which has more of the traditional colors, but they do throw in some pink in there. So I'm going to have more than enough paper and stuff to choose from, and embellishments for this album. I also, I'll go through those individually here shortly, but I'm also going to pull some different individual things. I'm just going to have some red twine on hand. I pulled these from my vacation stash because I'm going to find Minnesota and use it probably on the front page. These new Studio Calico, wood veneers because I have a lot of pictures of the girls in front of Christmas trees. I also, it was very snowy there because it was Minnesota in December. So, I have pictures of us in the snow. So I'm going to use those hopefully. Since I have 5 million packages of these, I'm going to try to use some of those up. These are new tags I got from TJ Maxx, so I'm going to try to use them. They're very bright and colorful, and I think will go with this album very well. I don't normally pull letters, but since I had these out, I wanted to go and pull these candy cane thickers. And I don't know if I'll use them or not, because I may use these for the really Christmassy pages of us in front of the Christmas tree. But I don't know if I'll be using a ton of red. We'll see what happens, I guess. But I have them out just in case. And then I also pulled this. This is actually from Walmart. This is We Are Memory Keepers Albums Made Easy. And this is actually the travel themed. But as you can see, there's a lot of these pinks and brighter colors in here. And so I thought I could intersperse this with the Christmas product. I also like that it has some purple in here because in a lot of the photos, I am wearing this purple sweater. And so I thought that that might help pull some of that color in a little bit. But we'll see. I need to open it and really dig into it to see if it's going to really work with these colors. I think it'll be fine. Excuse me. There's my sneeze, guys. I usually always sneeze during a video. Of course, this time I think it's because I'm sick. But I also pulled all my 6x6 paper pads that had any kind of pink or brighter colors in them, like the non-traditional Christmas. And so I have the Sleigh Ride from Crate Paper, which I think maybe that first. No, I think that's bundled up. So I have Sleigh Ride. As you can see, just brighter colors. Lots of pinks and stuff in there. My Mind's Eye, Tis the Season. And it has just little bits of pink in it. It's not a lot, but it has a little bit of pink in it. This Crate Paper, what's it called? Superior Quality. Oh, Peppermint Collection. This doodle bag, North Pole, and I don't have the tape undone, but it's very whimsical, which will be cute for some of those photos, I think, of the inside the game, or the amusement park part of the Mall of America. This is Glitz, Hello December. And I really like that yellow there. Peppermint, which is by Crate Paper. I don't have it undone either here. Wait. Maybe not. It looks very familiar with what I just did. Anyway. And then Cartabella's Merry and Bright. And then Sleigh Ride, which is the first one I showed you, so I must have two of these, which is okay because I loved it, so. Okay, so I have two Sleigh Rides, that's funny. So those are like the individual things I've pulled. I didn't really go through my individual baskets of embellishments because I figured I'd have enough with the kits. So very quickly I'll show you Studio Calico's Tis the Season. Like I said, this has more of a paler pink. I just wanted the stuff with pink in them because a lot of times my girls are wearing pink clothes or there's a lot of pink, like in the American Girl store, there's a lot of pink in there. So I wanted to make sure I had plenty of pink. This might be too pale of a pink. We'll see how that turns out. And then I also got the 6x6 pad as well. And I think I'm going to just put this with my other 6x6 pads. And then this sticker sheet here. So this is some more letter stickers I can use. Some more wood veneers that have words there. And some sequins. Or these are die-cut plastic shapes. I'm sorry. They're not really sequins. But those will be really cute. These are Studio Calico stickers, which are cute. Those remind me of the ones I just got from TJ Maxx that were American Crafts. They're very similar. These pockets that have sequins in them. Love those. That'd be really pretty. these tags that are craft and have the red twine. I also have some really nice sentiments for this trip. Some more plastic shapes. I think these are snowflakes, and these are like, looks like word bubbles of sentiments. Flare. And some die cuts. Vellum and chipboard. Turn around real quick. Okay. And then some sequins. It looks like they're gold and red and silver. Sorry, lighting isn't the greatest. And some pockets, which just might be good to put in some of the ephemera. Okay, so that's the Studio Calico. And then I also have this October afternoon, and I have not used this line, either of these lines at all. That last one I will have opened already, but this one I haven't. So I'm excited to play with some new stuff here. So this is Silent Night by October Afternoon. And first off, I have these two washies. Sorry, guys, it's dark outside, so. These brads. These die cut shapes. These doodads. These pins. This really fun stamp, which I forgot I had. I think that will go well with at least our Christmas Day photos when we were at like a zoo. I think those will go really well. This So Fun banner. Oh, these letters. So I got some more letter options. These are chalk and slate. Stickers. Labels. I have not, like, seen these since I first got them. These border stickers. So these are so cute. I like that that has a map on it. That'll go really well, actually. The chip and sticks. And I love these letters. Here's stickers. And the stickers here. And the papers. And I'll just kind of flip through them. I'm not going to go through each individual sheet, but oops, I have a random flare there. Not for sure that's from. It says Burr. That's funny. Let's see. Maybe this without. Oops, sorry. I'm not doing a very good job here. Let's try it this way. Yeah, okay. So I'll have some cut apart sheets, looks like. Those are hard to flip through. Sorry, guys. You get the idea, though, and this is an older line, so you've probably seen a lot of these. Squeezy paper will be perfect for, they have, like, music constantly playing, like Christmas music, like live bands and stuff in the mall, so that'll be fun. So I think I have a picture of that. Okay, so there's that. And then this is, I think, bundled up, and I've already used this, and I think I have some extras added into here as well. So let's see what I got here. Getting a full table here. So it looks like I have a bunch of different embellishments and sequins and stuff here that probably loose. There's flair in there. And oops, sorry, lots of sequins and some, it's like words and stuff in there. So just a variety of goodies that I must have packed in there for when I put this kit together initially. There's a sequin there. And then here's some scrap paper, so I'll try to get this used up. Here's some white scrap paper, so let's put it up on there. I think I'll probably use this, or cut this packaging for it to actually try to use it. Very fun, that just very much goes along with the feel of this album right there, I love that. This here, hopefully I have enough paper, oh yeah, I have a paper pad, or the 6x6 pad to use, oops.
Uh-oh. We have sticker issues. Hopefully I'll try to still use that. So I have quite a few stickers left that are all falling off, and hopefully I'm not ruined here. Well, that's kind of a loose little love sticker there. I'll try to keep it there. But yeah, very cute. I have a few brads there. And then the paper pad. Cute. And then some more flair. And looks, yeah, this is all stuff I'd pulled from my stash, it looks like, because this is not part of bundled up. So here's just some random pieces that I must have had with that kit. This is from the line, I believe. So I have some leftovers there. I'm missing the S there. That's not good. I'm sure it's somewhere. Oh, there it is. And then... And then just a whole bunch of die cuts, it looks like here, like leftovers from when I played with it last year. So it's sticky there. Oh, see, I don't know how this happens. Okay. So some of these are those stitched borders, those pre-stitched. So this is a mix of all of that. And I think I did a video on this paper line, some more twine. I think I made quite a few layouts from this, actually. Looks like I still have some overlays in here and some cards. This I've gotten the drilling card pack, Project Life pack or whatever. And lots of goodies here. So I have plenty to work with, even though I've already scrapbooked with this paper line. So I'm excited about that. Here is the chipboard. Yeah, I didn't hardly use any of this. Looks like. And then the paper pad, which I kind of already showed you with the, so like, oh, there's a cut apart, so I'll get those cut apart too. I think that of all of them, this paper is like the best fitting for this album, I think. At least some of them are anyway, so this will be perfect. I'm so excited to finally get to work on this album. So there we are. That is my huge kit. I'm really excited to start scrapbooking this vacation, and I'll be back when I have some of it done. I don't know if I'll get it all done before I show you guys. I might kind of do some and then put it away and do some more and just update you as I go. So we will see you guys later. Thank you. Bye-bye.